because it's supposed to tell them and make them hear you.
Okay. Come, you guys.
We can't see it.
All right, everybody pay attention.
Okay, everybody pay attention. Look. Okay, I'd like...
1, 2, 3
Okay.
4, 5, 6
I'd like to introduce you to Mr. Bromfield. He's the owner of the property here, okay? And it is both he and I who are working together to help create a permanent site for you guys in Jamaica right here. And this is called the Jireh Eco Adventure Park. And the focus is on natural environment, okay? But fun too, as you can see from some of the rides and more, which we'll be catching further out. So I'd like you to give a big yagi.
Ready?
To Mr. Bromfield.
Yagi!
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 Yeah!
Yagi, yagi, yagi!
Yeah, yeah, yeah!
All right.
Thank
so,
you.
We're going to go get check out a campsite right now. So just want you to be patient for a few minutes. And then we'll be right back and we'll start to set up camp, okay?
Yes.
All right. So we'll be right back.
Okay.
All right.
How many youngsters do you have here?
28 or 27? 28. 28. Yeah.
Okay, great.
All right. All right.
I was trying to get this generator started.
Yeah.
When I got the other one. But we start and use it twice, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I think it's some pull power, maybe a few hard draws.
Yeah. All right.
Temple. Thomas Temple. And that's where the place got the name from.
Temple.
What is the name of the place? Temple Hall.
Temple.
So at that time it was 3,000 acres. And in the 18s it went down to about 1,500 acres. And I have the original maps, if scouting wants to keep the original map, when the original map, where it was. And now this property is 100 acres. It goes straight up to the hill. Those are squatters up here.
Yeah, the guy was telling me they were going banana up there.
Hill and across. It doesn't go as far as that.
The post, the road, light pole.
You can see the last quarter, basically like a brownish light.
Yeah.
That is where the hill, the property starts turn around on the hill. So it goes over to a little town called Mount Friendship.
Okay, welcome one and all. We're in the waning hours of the day. We're finally on property, but had some setbacks. The team that was supposed to bring our trees and our tents has not brought the tent. So now we're walking onto the property where the great house is. This great house, 300 years old from slavery days, predates the United States as, you know, the full 50 states that is. Okay, so we're walking now to do a tradition that we're gonna start every time. There are a number of pine trees that I've been growing at my house for about 2 years from pines that I ate. And we're gonna plant them here to, you know, as a gift to the future. To any other troop that comes here, our pack, who wants to eat, you know, pine or drink lemonade. We have some pine trees and some lemon plants. So everybody line up. Have you figured out where we're going to plant it?
All right, we have a
stuff. All right, so gentlemen, say hello to the world.
Hello.
Hello, world.
All right. Better than that. Give me a yagi.
Yeah.
Yagi.
Yeah.
Yagi, yagi, yagi.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yagi, yagi, yagi.
Yeah.
Big dog,
roof, roof.
Big dog,
roof, roof.
Big dog,
roof, roof.
Lick a pup, lick a pup.
All right, guys, now let's just show. Hold up what you have. So today, in our tradition, we're planting this pine tree.
Lime.
And here's lime tree. And here's another lime tree, right? What's your name, sir? This is for history.
Orange Griffiths.
Orange Griffiths is going to plant this. And who's next? Your name, sir?
Nathaniel Ray.
Say your name loud.
Nathaniel Ray.
Nathaniel Ray is going to plant this. Now we have some pines here, so let's pull them out the bag. All right. And you're going to be digging the ground. Your name, sir?
John Williams.
John Williams. Excellent, excellent. We have the pines here. You can pull them out the bag now, you know. So, all right. So these pines, ladies and gentlemen, are the heads of pines that I ate almost 2 years ago. So, gentlemen, just a point here. It is smart to grow trees that will feed us. Who agrees? Good idea, right? What we are about to plant is limes that made lemonade for me and pines that I ate. I didn't throw away the head. I put it in the ground. This used to be a little saw. And now look at them. And what this is going to do is feed a future generation. So this is a tradition we want to establish. If you ever have a house or anywhere near you, you can plant something. Guess what? Do we throw away the heads on plantable seeds? What will we do with them now?
Reuse them.
Put them in the ground. Right? We're going to pay it forward. So now we have a site here. Mr. Bromfield has offered. Did he mention where we could put it? All right. Shovel man. You have the shovel. We need to find a spot we can put the pines. If you can clear here, over there. All right. So let's go start digging. All right, gentlemen, let's go. We're going to put these in the ground. All right. So careful with the pines. Those needles, if it juke you, you're going to feel it for the rest of the night. You have the bag of limes there, sir? As you go. Oh, what's your name? I didn't get you. What's his name? Nice and loud, man.
Omarion McGowan.
And you have a bag of limes. So these little limes are for the cubbies to pop open and sink into the ground. So, all right, guys, let's go. Let's find a spot. Somewhere it won't get moved. Anywhere convenient. You know what? Maybe right here would be good, you know. Little bit of shading. What do you say about right here? See right here? Is the earth soft? Because who knows about pine? Hey, 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 gentlemen, stay with the group. Huh? Okay, all right, but don't go too far. I want to keep the group together. All right, gentlemen, right here we're going to plant them. Here, why is it smart to put it under a tree? Is anybody going to be here to water it?
No, sir, the tree
you got to say like this, not me, sir. All right?
The tree supplies with nutrients.
Okay, and that too, yes. All right, and it's going to keep it shaded, so if it's in the drought, it gets a little opportunity to grow. Now, can we put the lime tree under there? No, why? How tall does a lime tree grow? Up to here. Up to here and way past this tree. So it's going to compete with the tree. We don't want to put the lime tree there. So the lime trees don't go, but we're going to put our pine under here. The pine easy. The root is small. So space them out good. Give it a good, maybe 5 foot in between. So spread them out wide. Is concrete under there? Is concrete or dirt?
No, it's good.
All right, so while he's doing that, who has a little shovel? My little lime tree, guys, little shovel. Who have the little shovel? Tell you. All right, so cubs, come with me, cubbies. You know what? Let's find a nice place to put our lime tree. Where can we put it? Where can we put it? You know what? Wow, it's so bushy. Anywhere good. Where could we put it? Eh? Say hi to the people.
Hi.
How do you like the sight?
Sight?
Are you excited? Have you seen the go-karts yet?
Yes, sir.
You saw the go. Have you seen the swimming pool?
Yes, sir.
Is it a good thing?
Yes, sir. We want the whole of them set up right now. Mm-hmm. So we can all the go-kart just jump around that.
All right. Good, good. So we're going to get the go-kart tomorrow. But remember, to be on the go-kart, you have to be on what?
Best behavior.
And I'm watching. I'm watching. Huh?
The pool.
Yes, we're going to the pool tomorrow. We should have gone today, but it got dirty, so they're cleaning it now. So tomorrow, but again, only for best behavior. Right? So we want everybody to cooperate. So while they're digging up, making the pine spot there, let's do our job here now and find an area we can put our lime tree. And you know what? I'm thinking maybe. See, it's so bushy. Oh. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, part of the problem has been a lot of rain here, and it's made it very tricky to find spots to plant things. As you can see, a lot of bush. So, guys, where you think? Hey, come, where you think is good? Anybody have any ideas? Where could we put our lime trees? Yeah, because I don't want them to cut it down. See, with all the bush around. Wow. But you see, if they mow down our political lime tree. Ah, dear. Kitty, we didn't have a set area. You know what? All right, we just do our best. Let's see. Well, you know what? Let's keep it near. You know what? We'll put it right by here. What do you say? What's moving the tree? Oh, there's a monster on here now. Man beast, but we'll talk about him later. So you cubbies, I have to warn you, we don't want anybody straying, because if you stray, man beast will get you. You don't know about man beast, but I'll tell you the story of man beast later. So come. Man beast, half man, half beast, used to be a scouter. didn't listen, got lost, was raised wild, and he has long teeth and claws, and he eats little cubs. He followed them all over the world. So anywhere you're going to have a campsite, you have a man beast. And what that means is when you're in your tent, you're not supposed to come up. When we say lights out and stay inside, you stay inside. If you listen real good, you might hear him in the bush. Because he's not brave enough to come in the camp because the bigger boys can fight him. But nice little tasty little cubbies like you saw. Mm. He just lick his lips like this. Mm. Mm. And has long dagger teeth. So one bite, that's it. All right. No, you don't believe it?
No.
Not if you believe it. Like I said, many have doubted. Straight out of your tents and you'll know. All right, so you got it good? All right, don't forget, give it to room, you know. Give them room. So don't put them too close because they grow very big. All right, so the lime tree. All right, guys, you know what? Right here. We might need a little help with the shovel just to clear some of the bush away. You know what? We put our lime tree right here. So, all right, we got a spot for the lime tree right here. Right here, yes. So he's going to clear the spot. So just bush it back. I'm sorry to have a cutlass. Use it like a cutter. Everybody, whoa, what's the danger here? What's the danger? Move those little feet. See the shovel front? That is a digging shovel. It will cut your foot. So let's back up. I see a lot of nice soft feet. No, sir, that is a nice proper shovel for digging. You see how the front is shaped like a spade? Yes. You come in? No, man, the monster's not going to come like that. He don't come in the night, daytime, you know. He's afraid of the day. He's out in the bush. He might shake a bush, but he's way out there. No, watch. But at night time, you have to stay where? Inside your tent, that's right. Because he only catch you the moment you put your little toe like this. Right, the little toe there. Wow! He can grab that and yank you out and drag you right to the bush. You just see the bush shaking as he's dragging you away. So, what's the smart thing to do? At night?
Stay inside.
Yeah, no problem. Now, if you have to come out of your tent, let's say you need to go to the bathroom. What do you say? Leader, I need to what? I need to go outside, right? Don't scare him. Right? All right. Stand back, gentlemen. All right, so bush it up for them, yeah? All right, who has the lime tree? Hold up the lime trees, let me see. Who has the lime trees? All right, good. So, guys, again, attention. Here we go. Attention. All right, he's clearing the bush. Yes, Miss Ozzy, say something, man. I was going to say something very loud. Oh, that's it. Hold that for me. Hold it for me. Thank you. All right. Let me grab it here. All right. Here we go. Attention. You gentlemen, step back. Back. I don't want anybody's foot to get dig. I have an emergency kit. I don't want to use it. All right. He's going to clear the bush right here. Now, why is this a good spot for the lime? Anybody? Why? Because lime trees start little like you, and then they do what? They go whoop, pow, way up here, right? So we don't want, if you put it under the tree, what the big tree gonna do? Get out of my shade, I'll push it down, and it'll never get to grow high, and we'll never get lime off of it. So we want to have limes for what? We make limes and Dubek.
Make lime juice.
Lime juice, that's right. All right.
Lemonade.
Well, lemonades would be what? Lemon. Ah, limes is making lime juice.
Press it again.
Beep.
No.
Hello. Oh, it's off. All right.
Press it on.
Now, how are we doing with the pine? Remember, give at least, you know, 4 or 5 foot around. Spread them out.
I'm not afraid.
All right, so lime trees, gentlemen, lime tree. Already, you can dig now to plant, you know. All right. Don't know. All right, so he's got it good.
Hello.
No, that's not the mic. This one, say hello.
Hello.
All right. You've got a big voice, sir. Oh, my gosh. All right. Now, who's ready to swim?
Me!
Who knows how to swim?
Me!
Who knows how to do doggy paddle? Let me see your doggy paddle. Let me see some doggy paddle. Let's see some doggy paddles. What is that? Oh my god. That doggy is drowning.
Hello. Good morning. Good morning.
All right. Now, all right. Now, watch it. We're going to get ready. Boy, you're going to bush the whole thing. Wow. All right. I think we have room for at least one. So let's get one planted. Dig the hole. Yeah, man. At least one lime tree. You can't put two lime trees next to each other. It's a tree, you know. Oh, all right, so gentlemen, everybody, gather around. We're going to plant our first lime tree. All right. Like I said, this lime tree gave me some delicious lime juice, and now it's going to serve a future generation. Let's see, everybody's watching us. Say hi to the world. Hello, world.
Hello, world.
Hello. Hello, world. All right.
See
everybody? Yep. Say hi to the world. Hello, world. See?
Hello, world.
This is people all over the world who want to help us set up Camp Wakanda, right? Is that right, ladies and gentlemen? These are the children who are the first pioneers for Camp Wakanda. So we're here, going to set up tonight. Oh, from Brazil, Almafa. Let us know where you are. So wherever you are in the world, say hello. All right, there's Maryland. Hello, Maryland. Hi. All right, and so we're here, and we're right now setting up a tradition of planting lime trees. Hey, don't go too far that. All right, of planting lime trees and pine and any useful fruit. Some of these lime trees are going to serve. New York, Minnesota. Hey, Minnesota it's nice there now, right? I know it gets cold. Minnesota can get real cold, ice and snow. It's near a lake, so you get a lot of cold weather. So what we're doing now? We're going to put these plants in the ground as a tradition that every troop that comes through here leaves something for a future generation. The idea, you get it, of paying forward, of doing some work, not necessarily for the benefit to accrue to you, but to accrue to a future generation as a gift to the future. So I want to instill that, you know, that thinking in all the kids here. So that's what we're doing. All right, guys. So here we go. All right, have you been to Brazil? My brother's gone. He loved it. Now she'll be going there soon. All right, lime tree. There we go. I'm going to spin the camera around now, guys. Say bye, everybody. I'm going to turn the camera on. Too deep. You know, take it out of the thing. Shake it out gently. Uh-oh. Shake it out of the base gently. And then, and we want a photo opportunity. So when we don't plant them. Yeah, hold on. Let me put this over the shoulder because this thing, I don't want to kill out the battery. All right, so. You know, can you handle this? Yes. All right. So, let me point at me here and hold this. So that's charging it. Yeah, good. All right. My assistant Sean has got it. So Sean's gonna take over here while I do the duty with the camera. All right. Where's everybody?
Everybody.
Hold on.
Sean, this is
Right. Yes. So, yeah, man. Yes. All right. You got it.
All
right, gentlemen. Everybody, return to the site, please. Do not spread out. There are dangerous things over there. Please stay on point. All right, come. Everyone, let's go. Chop, chop. Last man here is going to be the last man in the pole. It's going to be the last man on the bumper car. It's going to be the last man. We're watching. You see me? I'm good enough. I can memorize every face. I see you. I see you. I see everybody. I even see a man back here. Somebody stand behind me. I just saw. All right. Okay, so guys, let's go. I focus on the kids more than the dirt. All right, guys, let's go. Dedication time. All right, so how are you guys doing with the pines? You ready? Remember, guys, pine gentlemen. Remember. If you misbehave, what won't you do? No go kart.
No pool.
No moving.
No moving.
Yeah, do good things, then it's yes.
Yes.
Okay. Ready?
Good morning, Brazil. Good morning.
All right, so you have guys. Look, one lime in the drone, so you can focus on the lime right there. Look.
Gentlemen, why is it I'm talking and everybody is talking? I'm watching you. Don't take me for joking, you know. Somebody gonna be crying like this. I never hey, to Master Chief, and no, I can't go on the right.
Sir,
gentlemen over there.
Sir,
I need silence. I need silence. Who's talking? All right, let me start memorize people's face.
Hey!
Who's still talking?
Nick! What, man? Jaima, what, man?
Jaima?
Okay. Now we want a little devotion statement here to bless this plant that we put in the ground for the future, that it may grow strong and feed someone. Or many people, many scouts to come. Maybe you're yourselves as you get older, right? May grow what?
Beast.
Strong and healthy. All right? Don't forget, you were here this day. The very first camp was at where? Camp what?
Weir.
You know the camp name?
Weir.
Camp Wakanda. Who has seen the movie?
Black Panther.
Right. And in the movie, the place is Wakanda. Well, this camp is going to look in the future just like Wakanda. And this is the first steps we're taking. This lime tree is going to be part of the defense. Did Wakanda have defenses?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, well, guess what? Any of you ever fall into a lime tree before?
Yes, sir.
Is the worst stick you ever get in your life. All next week, it's still on.
Now I get you, yes,
sir. Come on.
Find the right one. Find the right one.
What else is it?
You can't plant as you know that maybe.
I'm not sure.
Govern.
Fine for the what?
Fine for the what?
The what?
We don't know. Fine for the what?
Fine for what? Want something?
Clear out around it, man. Clear around it. Clear all the crutchy men. Oh, we had them. Take your time with it, man. Clear out them something, man. Clear out the weed. Yeah, take time. No, man. Take time, man. Yeah, root up around it, man. No, man. Yeah, sit there, you know. Just...
Yeah, man.
You cover, man. Just...
Hey, boost me now. Laugh for dinner.
All right, we just plant one more and see where we can go.
Good?
Yeah, pull it apart. Don't kill yourself trying. Alright. So,
I'll two pen up.
Firewood.
Okay. I have a mission. Everybody line up, small to big.
Use this scout.
We need to do this fast before the light goes off. The bigger scouts have to do it, right? Yeah. Alright.
But you have anything to
scouts can help to spot out what we need, so we need firewood, we're gonna have a real fire. And you say fire. We want a real fire. But we need firewood. No, bigger scouts. Scouts, hold up your hand.
Go over there, sir.
Ready scouts, man. Scouts, hold up on your hand.
I'm green, man.
We need some firewood. That came out wrong. We take it back.
Firewood, fire stick.
We need something to burn.
Sticks.
Before when it gets. Look here. There, let me warn everybody.
Fire logs.
There is no electricity here. There is no moon out yet. So when it gets dark, it's going to be black. That means you do so.
Fine for
the day. All right. Then
no, it's okay.
Right. Pay attention. We need to light a fire. Now, who has their flashlight with them?
Wakanda forever.
All right, we soon have to go get that. Now, I'm sorry that the tents are not here. We should have set up camp a long time.
Huh? The pool.
What about the pool?
There's a pool.
We were going to swim at the pool earlier, but time run on. So we have to pick and choose what we're going to do. Pool too late and too cold and too dark. We then up in the water in the blackness and you draw it. Nobody's going to be able to save you. Okay? So what we have to do is be what? Use your brain and be what?
We're going to hold up on the prayer.
We know light dropping. We know there's no power here. And there's nothing to illuminate here. So unless there's a very bright star, it's going to be this. It's a fooling you know because the sun's disappearing over the horizon. And don't forget, tonight we have what?
Luna!
Star party? And it says star party? That means we will be seeing the moon through a telescope. Who knows what a telescope is?
Want something?
Hands up. I have one telescope? No. Not two. No! I have three. Binoculars too. We're going to see it because the moon tonight does something very special. The sun is going to be here.
Look that way.
Shine like the sun. Do like this. Look at the sun. Shine like the sun. Come on, like this. You fall up like the moon, man. You're bright. Shine like the sun. So, boom. He's the sun. This is the earth.
I have the moon.
And guess what? Somebody come. And either you, sir, you look like the moon. Come here. Come on. Come on. He's the moon. Now, if he's the moon here, he's the earth there, and he's the sun, where is the moon? In the shadow of the earth. But because the earth and the moon are close, the light actually comes from the sun, right? It comes from the sun, and it bends around the earth, you know, like... And it hit the moon. But the earth looks what color? So it takes away all the blue. And you know what it leaves? Red. Red moon tonight, like his shirt.
Blood moon.
Blood moon. Well, yeah, he knows. You know, blood moon. Blood moon. Listen. Gentlemen. Hey, what we not doing the own show back there? Hey, care to entertain us, please?
We ain't put in there.
All right, pay attention, because this is part of tonight's show.
Too much travel.
Guys, cameraman, you're focusing on the wrong thing. Them feet ain't interested. What's happening over here is the thing. Because listen, gentlemen, tonight, guess what? I'm going to teach you about how everything came to be. Look around you. Everything. Who knows how everything came to be?
Creation.
I have a different story. It's part of creation, but have more detail. And guess what? We're going to watch a movie. That is going to... No, not Black Panther. Black Panther is tomorrow. Tonight we have something different. We're going to learn. You're going to hear it from me first. I'm going to explain it nice and easy. And then we're going to watch that movie. And it's going to teach you everything from the beginning of time to now. Now, are there any other plants to go in? You guys have got those?
Godzilla.
Or vines in the ground? All right. Here's what we're going to do now. It's getting dark. And listen, the night is coming alive. Can you hear it? Wait, everybody quiet. Let's listen to the night. Shh. You hear it?
No, that's not me. That's insects.
Insects of the night. Right. Well, that's the night noise, right? And we're going to be surrounded by it tonight. Because this bush is wide. How many of you ever sleep in the bush before? Nobody?
Yeah.
Nobody ever sleep in the bush? All right. Well, tonight is going to be a first night in real woods. Real bush. All right, but we need our flashlight. So listen, we're going to break now and go back to main camp. We're going to get our flashlight, right? Who doesn't have a flashlight?
Me.
What? Oh, sorry for no. You're going to, no, I'm not reaching in to give you that. What I'm checking out is my laser beam.
Oh, nice.
Laser beam.
Let me try.
Because we're going to be using this, not the timing. We're going to use this.
Yeah, we're camping
tonight, okay? But I want you to get your flashlight. So who has flashlight? Hold your hand up because it's about to get dark. Who has flashlight?
Yeah, flashlight.
One man.
So far.
Wow, we better stick together. Man, beast gonna have a lunch tonight. He's gonna say, I'm sorry. You're all right, man. No, you know what? I'm going to put my special protection on him. You know what, my friend?
Are you afraid of man being? Are you getting so much trouble?
My friend, you know what I'm going to do for him? I have a special
anti-man
bee spray. Anyhow, you spray it, him come to bite you, him do so. Run! You are special, you get it, you alone, you are a friend, you are a man, 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 you I'm not afraid of people. But if you go by yourself, we're just going to hear.
I have to.
We just have to call mommy and daddy and say, oh gosh. Hey God.
All right, so don't remind me look, later. Listen, remind, what's your name, sir?
What's your name?
Say your name. All right, later, we're going to get the special spray for you. You will be protected. All right? He's very little. We have to give him the extra defense. But the rest of you, you better stay in your tent. All right? What do you mean, dog? Why am I making it up? No, look at my face. Look. Cubbies get to spend outside, right? Because normally them don't camp outside. They camp in the building where it's safe. So we set up the tent outside. And the next day, the cubbies came out like this. Mandis was there. And I said, joking, stop telling lies. They said, no, he was there. Because I let them know the story and I told them, don't come out your tent. And they stayed in their tent. And they're lucky. Because you know why? Tell you how we know it was him? Him have a claw like a bear. You ever seen bear, American bear? With furry, big, and a big pad on it. Almost like the gloves, but all the ears are claw. I told them, I said, man, beast is out here. What would he leave on the ground? Because it had rain and the ground soft. So what you going to see? I never believe it. And the youth, them go out in the bush and say, oh my gosh. And then quite out, just see the big paw prints, them going out into the bush. Right around the tent where he was in. Two of them in the tent. And they said they was scratching at the tent, trying to pull the zipper for them tent zip up.
And
try and get his little hooking finger into the zip hole to drag it down to pull one of them.
Man,
anyhow, he set even a toe.
As in man and beast.
That's all he needs. Just grab that twine. Right into the wood, fast, and by the time we turn around, it's gone. So that's a warning to say what? When we set the camp up, it is a defensive camp. Now, normally, you're lucky. I was a scouter like, oh no, back in 1986. And I tell you, every camp we had, guess what one guy had to do for at least two hours? Sit up and watch. Everybody else asleep. And him have to watch. Anyone sleep, so? God help you. Because you know what? To make everybody sharp. Every tent where other man watching, him watching for danger, but guess what else him watching for? Yeah, I want to see if you sleep. Anyhow, you sleep, you know, I'm just waking squaddies. Yo, let's go. Toothpaste, powder, and water. And you know it's coming. I'm going to the tent. And every man take a man. Sauce him up good with the powder. All right, line up the toothpaste in them palm hand. And if him sleeping real deep, squeeze it right in the mirrors. Go. Align it right. You see it? And then when you're ready,
you polish.
Huh? Every man line up a man. And you just decide, man, come out here. Because you see, what's going to happen? If I want to slap you out and your eye have something on it, what do you do? Put your hand full of toothpaste here. Well, poor zombie coming out like this. Yeah, but it's a lesson. What?
Don't sleep.
When you're defending who? Your camp.
Yeah, it's going to be dark soon. We don't have any electricity.
Right, the danger can be anywhere. So I like a little game, but it's a training.
We're going to be gone.
So I wanted you little puppies learning this through man beast, right? The only thing you need to do is what?
Man beast.
Is what? Stay in your tent.
when night time and lights out is come. So lights is going down now. Let us go back to camp. Okay? Don't trouble the man. Let him say. All right,
yeah, hopefully we'll be the campfire.
Alright, so let's head back now. So we're good. Gentlemen, good job. Give yourselves a hand. We have set the future. Woo! Good job.
Two lime trees. And four palm, what do you call it? Pine trees, sorry.
Oh, well, I'll have to go back in it. All right, guys. Oh, what did it say? Oh, you want to donate a tent? Okay. I'll tell you what, guys. We appreciate all and any help. You understand what we're trying to do here. You know, this is an opportunity to set the future straight. All right, so everything's planted. All right, good. Yeah, they could have given more room, you know, but all right, we'll take what we can get. The two limes are in the ground. Nice. All right, tomorrow we're going to have to get some sticks to protect them so that they don't mow them over. You know, and they have a chance, at least we can move them. But good job, man. Thank you. So, all right, guys. Again, yes, I always rewatch the scope. So I apologize. You know, part of the problem is that I have to perform and try and video at the same time. That's why Sean is here to help me. You know, he's excellent at this, man. So, you know, I need all the help I can get, you know. Love to be an octopus, but unfortunately, God only blessed me with two arms, two legs. So I'm doing my best, and I apologize if I'm not responding to your comments. You know, night is falling on us, and there's absolutely no electricity here. Zero, complete, nothing. So let me just make sure I have everything I need. But we will be following up. I will have, thank you, yes. And, you know, like I said, I'm going to have a post-camp scope where I can answer in full all questions. And, you know, follow up with you guys properly. I apologize. Right now, I'm just trying to give you a taste of what we're trying to accomplish here. Because tonight, I'm going to be doing a star party. I have a telescope from the Astronomy Association of Jamaica. The gentleman would have joined us to help with that show, but he is too old. He's in his late 80s, I think. So he wouldn't be able to manage here because it's just a very difficult piece of property. And I do have to show you something right here. We have some water here that is straight off of the hill. This is fresh spring water, what he's drinking right there. As a matter of fact, that water is better than what you get in the bottled water. It's absolutely A-rated by the water body, the Water Corporation of Jamaica, the National Water Agency, National Water Commission. Sorry, so. We have a great, I'm not on the channel. Oh, I don't know why. You know, either way, you know, I'm not concerned about so much the overall publicity right now. This is historical documenting of what we're doing here. So the website, I'm setting up a website. Wait, go ahead. You can drink first. Are you good? All right. I'm going to set up PayPal and GoFundMe and all of that. But I didn't want to do any of this prior, because I wanted to be sure that all the parties responsible signed off on this project. You understand? This is for the kids, and I want to make sure every penny goes straight to their, you know, benefit. So until I was clear with that, I didn't want to get started and then have to backtrack or refund or do any nonsense like that. Okay? So I just got to drink this. This is delicious. I brought a big water bottle to take some of this home with me. My mother would enjoy this. And here's Mr. Bromfield, property owner. The guys are working on fixing the pool. It got muddied up a bit, but we've got it working. Are you good with the pool? Getting nice now? All right, there's Mr. Bromfield, you know, who was working with me to dedicate this property to the boys of Jamaica and to make Camp Wakanda real. I'm hoping to scope the Wakanda area because, you know, we're in the front of the property. It's quite big. But there's a bear in the back that is as wild as Africa, man. It's the wildest I've ever seen. And it's untouched probably since slavery days. Yes, man. Hey, Mr. Bromfield, the people are saying salutes to you, sir, for what you're doing for the kids, man. You know, somebody is offering tents. So I'm going to follow up and see what else. What we'll do, Mr. Yeah, we have a number of needs here to get this property going good. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to compile a comprehensive list of where we can get started and how we can push forward. Because there's a lot to, you know, accomplish here, but it's going to take help and funds and whatnot. So, like I said, this is straight to the boys, man, to make sure they have a wonderful experience here. And a permanent campsite, because the amount of packing I had to do, literally almost 2 days of packing, just to have everything necessary to accomplish what I want to accomplish here. It would have been so much easier if we have a permanent site here, where we have a place I can just lock it up, and it's always here. And I only have to bring myself and who I need to bring, and we can, you know, get right to the business of giving these boys a wonderful experience and not have to worry about setup and getting things arranged and, you know, having delays. Because right now we don't have our tents. Night is falling and, you know, it just hasn't arrived in time for whatever reason, you know. So a lot of our very tight schedule, things have to get pushed off and so on. But this is the first time. I didn't expect it to go 100%. That's fine. You know,
the boys are enjoying themselves regardless.
Yes. Yeah, they're having fun already. And you can't not have fun here. Yes. It's a great place. So, you know, it's a great start, man. And, you know, I'm glad to see them here enjoying themselves. I knew this would go well. And we've just scratched the surface. Tonight's a star party. I'm waiting for the moon to show up and Mars and Saturn. And we have two telescopes and a pair of binoculars to work with. Yes, indeed. The troop, what is the troop name? That's a good, which troop is it? Okay, this is... Okay.
Because you can light it.
Yes. All right, okay. So the troop is from St. Thomas. And they've traveled all the way to Kingston to be here. So they've come quite a distance. But what I'm trying to do is make sure that this is a permanent site for international scouts as well. Any scouts around who want to come in. Because remember, this place has go-karts, bumper cars, you know, amusement park rides, so merry-go-round, you know, tilt-a-whirl. It has a, what you call it, the virtual reality machine, the one that goes up in the air and dips and moves, you know, to recreate the simulation of motion and that type of thing is here. And he has not one, but two of them. There's another one stuck in New York. We just need to get funds to bring it down. We need a bigger mower here, you know, the one that you sit on, because he only has a hand push mower for hundreds of acres, man. And it's difficult. The kind of grass that grows here is a real difficult sawgrass type stuff that goes to the sky and grows real fast and thick. So we need to get troops coming here on a regular enough basis that it keeps nature at bay, at least in the areas where we want to accomplish the things we need to do. So it's going to require funding and, you know, more on a Patreon level where, you know, regular income is there to help keep the grounds under control. And remember, there's a whole great house back here. This is potentially a huge, you know, historical site once it's developed, because this thing is 300 years old. There's an aqueduct behind it, and you will probably catch this in the videos that I've done earlier on YouTube and, you know, subsequent to that on my in my Periscope history. So, so much to do here, so much we can accomplish. And again, I really want to rival or beat Disney. I'm super ambitious on this. There's enough here to make it really hype and to put a science museum. And I'm not aware of there being any in the Caribbean. Let's not just say Jamaica. I mean, a real proper science museum like the Natural History Museum or the one in Queens, you know, something really sizable, but built Wakanda style. Wakanda style. Now, that's what I'm talking about, tying in the Afro-futuristic sensibility, right? That connection back to nature, but yet high-tech, which we're going to need, because as I've been preaching and preaching in my scopes, AI is coming to take all the jobs, man. You have a horticultural diploma? Yes. Okay, well, look, any skill set you guys have, and this is part of it, that you can lend to the effort here, we are more than happy to have you contribute. If not just ideas, but your physical presence, if you guys can come and help, because that would be great. You know, I appreciate all the support you're giving, man, and really, it's going to go a long way, because there's a lot that can be done here, a lot. And this potential property here has a great, you know, opportunity to really develop something fantastic. I'm telling you, Disney level, there's no reason why not. You know, it's the hill behind here is massive. I can't show you now because it's dark, but we could literally pump the river water up about, it looks about 600, 500 feet high, and recreate that same waterfall you saw in the movie, right? Where I think T'Challa and Killmonger fight at the foot of it. We could do that. There's no reason why not. There's space enough here and trees enough to have tree houses where you can travel from treehouse to treehouse and never touch the ground. There is enough distance between the hill and the front to maybe have a couple thousand foot zip line from way up top. I don't know if you can see the hill, man, behind me, from all the way up there straight to the front of the property, and on and on and on and on. I mean, the opportunities are tremendous, because remember, there's an unlimited source of water that is so freaking pure. It's better than what you have in the bottle. We are swimming in thousands of gallons of the purest water ever. That, I mean, unfortunately has to chlorinate it because, you know, with algae and such in the sunlight, it'll go green. But, I mean, you know, theoretically, if we're able to pump it into the pool, and it's an infinity pool, 160 foot long by like 50 foot wide, you could swim and drink all at the same time. Yes. Oh, some perfect for food. Hey, let me tell you, and again, what I'm trying to encourage here is a connection back to nature. As you see, I had the kids plant trees, and I want that to be a tradition here, to plant useful things so that we can reap the bounty of the land for free, because that's a great way of turning it around, right? Sunshine is free, earth is free, relatively speaking. The rain is free, you know, and the plants grow here in abundance and very tasty. If you guys have never had Jamaican fruit, actually, you probably have, because we provide winter fruits to the United States and Europe. I'm not sure if that's still happening, but that was the case for quite a while. So, wow, the light's dropping here, guys. So, well, my star party is going to be great tonight. I can tell you that. I'm already seeing the stars pop out. And, you know, we're far enough from Kingston that we should have a perfectly black sky. So that's going to be wild. Wow, Canada, that's great. So I'm sorry this scope didn't get promoted, but hey, it is what it is, right? You know, again, it will be in the scope history. So maybe one that does get promoted later, they'll be able to, I'll be able to refer the viewers back to a promoted scope so that everybody can catch in. So, all right, you need to get stuff. All right, so I got to go, guys. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to retweet and support. I'm going to here put the link in because I do need to save my bandwidth for later. I'll try and scope some of the star party. And I have my equipment charging right now. So there, follow and share. And Kranjit feature earlier. Oh, yes, you did watch the replay. Great. Yeah, thanks, guys. Again, I appreciate all the help, man. You believe me, it's been a long 4 years of work trying to get everybody together. Sean can tell you, he's been here for part of the journey. You know, we've had our ups and downs, our, you know, good moments and our disappointments. I don't focus on the negatives because I really just want to keep looking to the positive and looking to the, you know, the advantages that we can, you know, take a grip of in order to make this project happen. And I'm glad to see, man, this is great. Literally our first official Camp Wakanda on the Jireh Eco Adventure Park land. Okay. And so far all's going great. We have all of Saturday and then we depart Sunday early back to home and on to future planning to make the next Camp Wakanda even better than the first, because the idea is to really have a continuous presence here to keep nature at bay and to make sure that the entire premises, you know, serves the function of aiding the kids of Jamaica. So with that, guys, thanks. And don't forget, as I always try to say, and I keep muddling this thing, I got to get it straight once and for all. If you don't know the past, you won't understand the present and you'll be lost in the future. So don't take these things for granted. Educate yourself. And once you have that education, reach out and make the world a better place, as I'm doing. So thanks, guys. Take care. And I got to go now because darkness is coming. And we got to handle what we got to handle before we're enveloped in the pitch black of the night. So okay,
today, ladies and gentlemen, what are we doing? We are playing the game of this. All right. Now, I have some players. You guys know what to do? Yes? You got it? Okay, let's set the board up. Now, I'm going to explain it to all those who don't know how to play, okay? You have white squares and you have black squares. You have white players and? Okay, so these are your two opposing teams. There's no significance to either other than one of these sides starts the game. And these are the white players start the game. If you're on all the opposite sides of the board, and it really doesn't matter which way I turn this board, right? It's still going to be what? The same number of squares. Anybody care to count the squares from left to right? Who would like to do that for me? Let's go. Count the squares from left to right. One.
Four.
Louder.
Four, five, six, seven,
eight. And going up. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So it doesn't matter. Right? Arrange your pieces, gentlemen. Now, observe. Do they all look the same? No, these pieces have different powers, right? They can attack differently. Now watch what we have. I'm going to point out the pieces. This one looks like a little castle. You see that? Like a little castle?
Yes, sir.
This is the rook. Can you say rook? All right, I'm just joking. It's a regular rook. It's the rook, right? Now the rook has a very special move. He can move laterally in any direction for any number of spaces until he runs into a piece. Are you paying attention? Hello, hello. Did we get that? The rook can do what? Move any number of spaces until he runs into a piece in any direction. Uh-oh. All right, go take care of your tent business. All right, the rest of you. Who doesn't know again? Let me see a show of hands, because I need to know who I'm looking at. Who doesn't know the game? Who don't know the game? I know you don't. Piece of it? All right. So that's, they started already. Well, if you notice, they're making certain moves, right? And these pieces move differently. So this knight, see how he looks like? Was this a, what does a knight ride on? Horse. The knight could move in an L. Three jumps in any direction with a twist at the end, okay? And I'll show you how that works. All right, let me back it up a little bit so you can see. There we are. Now, the knights can go 1, 2, 3, and he can jump over pieces. He could go 1, 2, 3. He can go 1, 2, 3. He can make three moves with a twist at the end. All right. Oh, but don't touch. Don't touch. They're playing their game. I'm showing you. Okay. You can make three moves. But I'm just simplifying it for them so that they get it. All right. Three moves in any direction with a twist at the end, as long as there's not another piece there. He can't land on a piece unless he's killing it. And he can only kill a piece of the same color. Nope. Opposite color. Yes, sir. Okay. Oh, you ready to serve food? All right. Okay. So, guys, we're going to break the game of chess here. We're going to eat. No? Okay. I'm glad to see. They're good at playing. Oh. Let's gather. Let's gather. All right. So, I wasn't able to show you the full game. But, you know, I always bring these little extras to be prepared. So that the kids can get a chance to play the game. Oh, you want to learn?
Yeah.
All right. Well, you're not involved with this. Don't you have to eat too?
All right. Let's,
you want to learn? All right. I'm here to teach you, friend. Don't worry. All right. So let's set all the pieces back. You know the game?
Yeah.
You want to explain it to him? I'd love to have you teach him. So. Oh, signs up. Sorry. Signs up. Signs up. Look. That means silence. The same prayers. Amen. It's a scout prayer. You don't know? Aren't you? Are you in scouts? You're a visitor. Oh, he's not in scouts. Oh, okay.
Yeah,
it's a scout prayer. All right, sorry. Oops. Okay, let me introduce you to this game, sir. All right.
So,
No, don't worry. Yes, they are going to be on. I'm going to explain it to you in a minute. Okay, so white takes one half of the board and black takes the other. We're going to move all the pieces back into their positions, right? So start moving your pieces straight back, all of them. Back, yes, all of them back. One, back to you. The board's not set yet. We can't begin the game until the board is set. Enjoying your meal there, youngster?
Thank you, sir.
Can I get some? I said no! Alright. So yes, move all of them back. All of them back. Alright, back. Okay. Alright, now I'll try to answer your comments, Injun, but I'm here teaching this young man how to play the game. Alright, so you have all the pieces. No, make sure your pieces match what I have. Oh, no, this isn't right. It's not right. This is not right. Alright, get our knights in the right position. Somebody want... No, patience, sir. You ready to learn it? How long you been waiting for this? A long time.
Long time.
All right. Well, you know what? You can remember at Camp Wakanda, you finally got your wish fulfilled. All right. No, man. Yes. No, pay attention, man. I'm going to explain it to you. So you're going ahead of yourself. All right. Are you ready for this? All right. Let me attach this to the table so I can free my hands to talk to you. All right. What do you know of the game? What have you learned about the game? Anything at all?
Not much. I know a few of the names. These are the pawns.
Right? Few of the pieces, right? Pawns. Any other names you know for the pieces?
This are the knights.
Knights, correct.
That's
all right. How about the king and the queen?
Yeah.
Easy one. So you know king and queen.
Yeah.
Bishop. The bishop has a tall hat. So which is the bishop? Right. And how many bishops you have?
Two
bishops, right. So you've covered them all. The only thing left is a rook. Rook. I play with the words, but it's the rook. All right. So now, what you need to understand is that they have unique abilities. Pawns are the simplest. So the pawns can go forward one play at a time. or initially two spots and then one after. So you have a choice when you're starting to jump this two spaces or just one. But once you make your move, every move after that is how many? One. One move forward. Now the pawn, that's how he moves, but that's not how he kills. He kills diagonally. Okay, so let's make a move. We jump upon one spot. You do the same. Just mirror what I do. No, no. Remember, he only kills diagonally. So how about we do a test kill? Bring him up one or two spaces. Your choice. Because we're playing the game now. No, no. Over here. Do what I'm telling you. Right. You choose two. Okay. I'm going to go one space. Now, what do you notice? Is he laterally or diagonally near that piece?
Yeah.
Diagonally. Does he kill laterally or diagonally? I know it's tricky. Diagonally. So what does that mean you can do right now?
Kill him.
Kill him. Take him out. Go ahead. Knock it out. Knock it out. So you have that piece. Put it in your chest. All right. See, that's how it kills. Now, here we go. All these other pieces have different moves. I have now... You don't put that piece under threat. Because guess who else can move laterally? Mr. Rook. And all he can do right now, if he's blocked, then he's trapped. He can't jump over pieces. But is there any piece in between him and me? Well, I don't want to say horizontally, because is this a horizontal move? No. So yes. Yum, yum, yum. Thank you. Any distance, as long as there's no piece in the way. If there's a piece in the way, he either has to stop in front of it if it's his own color, or he can kill it, as I did, if it's the opposing color, right? Right. As long as, right, like I said, he has to be beside. He can't push it out the way, right? So I just took that piece. So now you know how the rook moves. The knight, different story. This guy is fancy. Him no move regular like the rest. What he can do is make funky moves. Say funky moves. He makes funky moves. He can go like this, one, two, and then and switch over. So he neither moves just laterally or diagonally. He can switch it up in a way. He makes L moves. Think about that. So there's a rapping term. He makes ill moves, but L moves. Get it? Ill move, L move.
Within 4 squares.
Right.
Within 4 squares.
Right. So you have to start counting any move you make. So if he's right here, right, let's just say for argument's sake, who could he kill? Well, one, here we go. So one, two, three, or one, two, three, or one, two, three, and then one, two, three. You understand? As long as at the very end, you make a twist. So one, two, three, one, two, three. See that? One, two, you get it. Any move around in an L.
So we can't stop anyway in the 4 square.
Well, he's on the, well, I like to say three count. So once you start moving, you're going to one, two, three, right? Mm-hmm. So you jump off and make first step, second step, third step, either way, right? So you can go so, 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 over here. So he could take this one, he could take that one, right? He could jump in front of here and block him, but of course you could eat him. Anyway, you understand how the knight moves. So I'm going to take my knight out. But guess what the knight is doing? He's so slick. He's got mad skills. He can jump over a piece. As long as he ends up on a blank space or on an opposing piece, which he's going to eat. So I've just moved my knight out. Bring yours out too. Bring him out. This one right here. So make a move, yes? You have one of two moves you can make. Make the L. Right? Or where else could you have taken it? Starting from here. Right? So put him over there then, just for argument's sake. Now you know the knight moves. Got it? So we're good so far.
Yes.
All right, so you got your rook with his lateral moves, and you got your knight with his ill moves. He's a rapper, right? You got ill skills, ill moves, right? He makes the L's. All right, next now is Mr. Churchman himself. Bishop. See that? That's a church hat, you know. He's the bishop. Say bishop.
Bishop.
Mr. B. Mr. B can do fancier moves, but he moves in diagonals. You have the black diagonal bishop and the white diagonal bishop. So he's only ever going to be on a black space because he can't come off of it. He's locked into that white diagonal, locked into the white spaces. Okay, so here's what we're going to do now. We're going to move a pawn out the way, right? You have a free bishop there. We're going to make a bishop move. So I'm going to go one, two, right there. move your bishop, and he can move any number of pieces. So you could have moved him there. Where else could you have moved him coming out of there? Where else could you have moved him coming out from where you came? From where you came, where else could you have gone? You could have gone here or where?
Yeah.
No, man, can you jump over a piece?
No.
Only the ill mover. Who's the ill mover here?
Right here.
No, who's the ill mover? Who's got ill moves? L moves, get it?
Oh, L moves.
Right. I'm nice. Saying ill, get it? I'm trying to help you remember. He's ill, he's got skills. All right. So you got that. But the he can move either all the way out here or where else could he move? There's only one other space he could move.
Right here, sir.
Good. So you got that? Any direction as long as he's not blocked. And there's a free space, or as long as he's landing on a piece, he's going to eat. Are we good? Yes. All right, so you got the bishop. Now we're moving on to the power player, the queen. The queen, man, you have the queen, boss, you're the king. You're the king with the queen, because guess what? That queen can move laterally and horizontally any number of spaces. Her own limitation is that she cannot jump over a piece. So who's the ill mover that can jump?
She can move us in the black if you know, she's a white. Black.
But no, don't get confused. Don't go ahead of us now. Just bear in mind the movements, how they move. That's the first lesson, okay? None of them is an ill mover. The only ill mover who can jump over his own pieces and others is this guy, right? But the one who is all powerful but has that one limitation is the queen. So the queen there, queen can only move where she's free to move or free to attack. So she can be, but if this queen is here, and let's say you had, for argument's sake, what would be here? Your bishop here. Let's say this queen is right here. Can this queen do anything right now?
No,
she's trapped. She cannot come out of there. There's no free space to move into. But as you start moving your pieces out the way, right, and freeing up space now, now you unleash the power of your queen. So the queen, show me all the moves that queen can make right now. No, one by one. So she can go, but walk through it. She can go here, here, there, or go back. She can go here, there, right? Walk them out, walk them out. Yes, any direction, horizontally or laterally. That's why she's the queen. She gets what she wants, right? So just think about that. The queen has all the power. With so one limitation. Right? Yes. Right. She understand the queen can move any number of spaces, but she's trapped if she cannot come, you know, onto a space that's free or that she's attacking. All right. But guess what? Who's next?
The king.
The king. Now, you might think the king is the most powerful, but this is not true. He's the most scared guy in the world because everybody's out for his head. You see that crown there? They want that crown, my friend. Yeah. And they're out to get him because the moment you trap this guy with an enemy attack, guess what? It's over. You've lost the game. That's checkmate, right? So you're following this now? Now, you might think with all that power, he could do mad things, but guess what? He's limited. Just to show how life is, he may be elevated, but he's little better than the pawn. Because just like the pawn, and the matter of fact, the pawn have a little more power than him. The pawn can even jump two spaces. This guy is the reverse of the queen, where she can go anywhere.
He's doing this starting and can jump two spaces.
Right. Thank you. See, sharp guy it is. He's followed. I like that, man. I like that. Good, good. You're remembering. Because once you learn the king, we've gotten them all. The king now see him, they all want his crown. And once they have it, he's done. And that's the last. But like the queen, he has a power. He can move in all directions. The queen can move any distance. What do you think the king can move? Just take a guess. If she can go anywhere, in any direction, as long as it's free, right? She can make multiple skips. How far can he move from there in any direction? Take a guess. Three spaces, two spaces, just one.
Two.
Two, you think? Just one. Just one. He can go this way, that way, this way, that way, this way, that way, but only one. Right? That is his greatest limitation. He's big, you know, let's think of it as big and fat. He can't really walk so good. You know what I'm saying? He's overladen. He's eating all that good food, man. His servants and waiters have been hooking him up. So he's got power, but he can't go far. Got me?
Yes,
and not only that, but when he's under attack, can he move into the attack? Because they want his crown, he's always trying to protect the crown. You put the king under attack, can he, let's say the if he's under attack, like here, right? And this piece is protected, right? That means when he kills that piece, he's still under attack. Can he do that? Can he move from an attack to being still under attack? No. And this is how you trap the king and win the game. You attack with a piece and prevent him from moving anywhere. Can he go here and get out of attack? Is he still under attack by the queen? The black queen?
No.
Wait. Is he under? Look at it. Is he under attack by the queen? Where can the queen move? Anywhere she wants. Remember, she's a who? Right? Look at it now. So if he's here and under attack and he goes there, is he still under attack? Yeah, man. See? Because she's still getting
this
him.
Is the one that moves.
So guess what? Unless he can move from a position of attack to a position where what? He's not being attacked. So let's say he could squip over here. Let's say this wasn't here. Is he safe now? Look around on the board. Is anything attacking him from any distance at all? Is he under attack?
No.
No, he's good. So is he in check anymore?
No,
he's gotten out of it. Once checkmate means he can't get away from the attack. So let's bring that piece back. Where is it? The bishop. If the bishop is here and you manage a power move and you get him caught there, he's done for. Now, mind you, he can get out of this. Show me. Let's see if you figure the game out at any at all. How can you save your king right now? He's under attack. You have to stop that. You have no choice. Stop it right now. How can you stop that attack? He's got it, right? Just put that right there. Thank you. Guess what? You have now learned the game of chess. My work is done. You've learned it. Now just play games so that it's burned into your mind. But you've learned. That's all there is to it. Now mind you, there's certain little fancy moves that I haven't shown you. Like there are ways a pawn can move diagonally and take a piece called en passant. And there's a way that if you have certain pieces on the backboard and they haven't been moved, you can bring the king over like two and then bring the bishop, the rook over like that. There's certain little funky moves. But I don't want to confuse you. I just want you to understand how the pieces move first. And then you play games and you learn the thing fully. And then maybe one day you'll be the next chess grandmaster. And I tell you a joke. I played for Jamaica as a kid. My brother was much higher than me. They have rankings in Jamaica for chess games. And one of the guys I went to school with was very, very, very... He was Jamaica's number one chess player. And we played him many times. We always lost because you're just much better
can
than us.
Can they move forward or they can move?
Well, don't worry, man. It's in your mind. Trust me. As you play with him and as you win and lose, you'll slowly get the idea of it. And then you can learn techniques and little preset moves that you can run through and just defeat an opposing player very quickly. It's a game of strategy, you understand? It's a game of patience, caution, and looking ahead. Pay attention to the board because sometimes your opposer will trick you, right? He'll have moves that he's going to set you up with and do certain things to make you get greedy, and you go grab and yam it while he's setting up a separate attack and he distracts you with an easy meal. So if somebody move your queen somewhere and you know you could kill that queen and it look like an easy meal, don't just yam it, you know, my friend. Don't get played because he might be what? Setting you up. Mm-hmm. Welcome to the world of chess. Mm-hmm. Now I'm going to get a meal. Thank you. All right, guys. I'm going to go. Oh, thank you. All right.
Okay.
You know, help to start the spark, give back a little bit, you know, so that you can take the time to learn and explore. Once the general idea is in the mind, you'll remember, you'll have opportunity to go and do the research to fill in any gaps and, you know, keep going. So we're all going to eat our lunch here, guys. Thanks for watching. And, you know, I'll try and again scope more from Camp Wakanda. And if you guys don't know about the whole project and what's going on, I'll just simply refer you to earlier scopes I've shot where I explain pretty much everything we're trying to achieve here on the Jireh Eco Adventure property here. Right there. See the rides? In St. Andrew, just up from Golden Spring, past Stony Hill. Yes, sir. You want to play a game? All right, we'll get on to it, man. But I want to give him the opportunity. This man is here to learn it. So I'm glad I brought it with the very intention. I figured somebody would want to get the chance to learn. So there it is. So thanks for watching, guys. And
That's right. Now whip that horsey. Whip the horsey. Whoa. Whoa. Whoa.
Ryan.
Watch out.
Ryan, the horsey.
Watch out.
Get it. Ah. Get it.
Oh, she's going the wrong way. Get it. It's the way I should go. Yes, catch everybody's face. Watch out. Coming through. Coming through. Sorry, wait. Let me get ahead of you. Let me get ahead of you because I get in the back of your head. All right.
Just come on in.
Spank him. How's it go fast if you give him the spanking? You gotta spank him.
Stop it, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, hold on properly. No, don't do anything out of the ordinary.
That's where I am.
All right.
Yeah, get up, hold on, wait.
Get it. All right.
Hey.
Take time.
First 40, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Red hot. Take your time, everyone.
But did they need help opening it up, or you know, to open it up? They're easy to open, right? The...
Yes.
Okay.
Just pull the latch and go inside.
Michael. Take time. No, man, go in through. Whoa! The regular seating, right? Sit down. Yeah, just push it in. All right. There. All right. Sit down next to him. No. Look good. See that?
Yes, sir.
You're in.
All right.
Everybody in their seat. Everybody in their seat. Around and around we go.
All
right. All up on the monkey. Are we around? No man, not fire, the power. There you go. Electricity, yeah.
You are the doctors, you are the drivers.
Yes, sir.
Hold tight. You have to make the noise, you know, when you lift the button there, come on. Alright. Not too fast, slow it down, slow it down. Listen, my friend, you love the game.
Yeah. Come here, play, no?
Yeah? Right, being now, I need to feed you in 3 moves, man. You don't want me to play this. Yeah. Go on, work your skills, man. Work your skills. So you get it now. Look at this. From just learned to competent player. Wow. So much of your pieces, them tech, my friend.
Sir, big in
your, your. I don't know.
Sir,
I don't know.
Sir, beginner luck. Sir, beginner luck.
Beginner's luck. No, man, he's studying the game. Sir. More than just beginner's luck, he's studying the game. He loves it. When you love a thing, you'll be good at a thing. I'm very impressed, my son. Very impressed.
Check me out.
We're going to do it later if we get the chance. No. Let's see what the sky looks like. There's some cloud in the sky. But if it clear up, we have a chance. Look at this, ladies and gentlemen. He just learned today. And already he's doing so well. So well.
Bambi.
I don't have the paper on me. But it's all up to them, because sometimes they don't necessarily get to that. I mean, we did pretty good this morning. The guys are really with them in this game for this. Welcome, welcome. Well, guess what? Behold the Camp Wakanda infinity pool filled with the pure, clean drinking water from the nice, beautiful Okay, yeah, yeah, I got it here. Ready? Whoa! Here we go. Pull needle. Ball, ball, ball. There you go. Yes, yeah, from the streams coming from the hill. All right. So, I'll show you here. They can barely take up space in this pool. It's so big. It's not filled to full infinity size, but here, this gives you some idea of the scale. This is our entire 30-odd boys in the pool. And like I said, this is filled with the pure river water, man. A little bit cloudy because Mr. Bromfield had a friend of his dredge the upper part of the river to get sandstone for construction, and it unfortunately put some of the dirt in the water, so that's kind of sad, but anyway. All right. Oh, some disciplinary issues here. Not listening.
Your safety is more important than anything else.
That's right. All right, so here we go. Part of this again is purpose for recreation, having discipline while in the pool to learn to have control, self-control, and conduct yourselves appropriately. So that's right, man. This is all it's all about. So Mr. Brumfield was having some car trouble, so he's not here today, but we're here with the kids. So there we go. Having fun, cubbies! They're too busy to pay any attention to me. Woohoo! Right. So here we are. This pool is 160 feet long by about, I think, 50 feet at its widest. 45, 50 feet. Unfortunately, I can't swim. I missed the lifeguard today. So here we go. All right. But I'm glad the sun was in earlier, so it's out. And you can see the hills behind us. These are the Wakandan hills, I'm calling them, because they're just about as high as what you saw in the movie, maybe higher. And we're hoping to pump river water up there to have a gigantic waterfall cascading down. And there's an area on the interior farther into the bush where it's really wild, man. And yeah, it's like raw jungle when you see it. So the plan is to have that be, the campground in the future. Totally immersed in the bush. So we're at the front of the property now because it's overgrown, but once it's cleared and everything's ready, we'll have fun. So you can see we barely make a dent in the pool. It's so huge. All the scouts are on this side and the cubs are on the far side. And after this is going to be go-kart ride, so no, lots of fun here. Everybody got up. Well, I'm sorry, you guys missed a whole lot of wonderful stuff. Unfortunately, if I'm participating, I can't film at the same time. And sometimes I need my assistant to be involved as well. Everybody listen.
Check, check.
All right, so I do my best, but you guys missed some wonderful things. I did magic tricks. I did some, we did a morning run. I ran everything on time to teach these kids timeliness, so there's no slacking. I taught them about, disciplinary, games to learn how to get other people to behave, if they're not following along with you. I used the box from the movie Dune to teach them about letting the human side control the animal side. So many things. And again, you've missed it all. Unfortunately, I can't perform and film at the same time. So maybe in the future, I'll be able to film some of these techniques I use to help get these kids more in line with discipline, controlled behavior, while at the same time exercising, their natural instincts to have fun. We're not trying to stifle that at all. We simply want them to know when to turn it on and when to turn it off. And that's the magic trick, the best magic trick of all. Young man, having fun? Very good. So yes, this is a dream come true, ladies and gentlemen, what I've been working towards for years. This is the first step. These young men are the pioneers. As I told them, you're not number three, you're not number two, you are number one, the very first, camping here officially under the banner of Camp Wakanda. And once we get funding, we're really going to blow this thing out to be Disney level or better.
So you know, world-class attraction here on this massive estate. You know, I don't know if you can see again these huge hills behind you, but you know, we're surrounded by mountain here, not unlike what you saw in the movie. And we watched Black Panther last night, so everybody has seen the movie and has the full concept and dream in their minds here. So now it's time for the fun. And after this, the go-karts. So I'll try and read your comments. Yeah, it's huge. Trust me, one of the amazing things about this property, and I'm just sorry I wasn't filming every second of our experience here. It fools the eye. When you approach it from the front, it looks very small until you spend an hour walking just to the hills back there. When you see the level of bush, I mean, I'm talking about untouched since slavery days. Raw, unbridled, free-growing, untouched bush, and nothing dangerous, and that's a benefit, you know. This is all just, you know, safe but wild adventure for the kids, right? And for any of you who come here, this is just the beginning. This is just the diamond in the extreme rough. We're going to do a lot of work enhancing and improving this. So, you know, stay tuned. It's going to get a lot better. And again, with your help, you know, if we all pull together, we can really, you know, take this to the next level. And I say, I'm so sorry you guys have missed most of the most magical moments. You're only catching the stardust here, okay? The real magical moments have all occurred, not on camera, just for us to know and, you know, remember for the rest of our lives here. But I'll capture what I can, you know, bandwidth and what else, you know, I can, you know, spare here to make this happen. But I really want to go on to the interior where the, you know, Wakandan space is, the real Wakandan space. So you can see just what I'm talking about. Because as soon as I got there, immediately Wakanda came to mind. And a real wild, true, you know, in-depth experience there. So, wow.
Everybody having fun? Say hello to the world, man. Everybody's, and so, hello world.
Yes, man. I'll try and read your comments, ladies and gentlemen. Very difficult because a bright sun is in my eyes, man. I'm sorry I'm not catching on to it now, but I'll do my best, you know. But this is Jamaica, man. A lovely place to live. You know, Donald Trump better take a page out of our playbook about love of country. You know, this is real, you know, deep appreciation for what we have here, you know. Don't make no mistake, Jamaicans may come to other places in the world, but our hearts are always at home. And so how far from Castleton? Not far, not far. Castleton is up the road. Just up the road. And you guys, I tell you, you've missed a lot. We had Mars, the Moon, and Saturn in view. We did our, you know, our star viewing. We have, you know, we watched Black Panther, man. Everything's been happening. Sorry, so I hope I'm not missing... I know, Trump, don't bother, I know. We're not, this is a day where, trust me, Trump's on nobody's mind. You know, we're going to enjoy what we have. And what I'm teaching these kids is we've got to become self-reliant. And this is part of that process of getting these kids involved in, you know, doing things in this country to help, you know, make it far more resilient to natural disasters, to internal issues. You know, this is part of the dream here. So let's go join the cubbies. I see my man. You're just taking your time here, sir, huh? Enjoying and relaxing. Very good, very good. All right. So let's... can the kids go to the pool anytime they want outside the camp? Not at the moment. It's really organized trips because Mr. Brownfield is trying to get everything up to speed. Let me be frank. He really extended himself to hold on to this property, and it's cost him a lot of money. And, you know, there are negatives to Jamaica, and that is some of the people in the neighborhood have come in here and stolen a lot of the things that he has set up. Ah, there you go. Say hello to the world. Come, say hi. What's your name? Come swim over. Come on, come. Say hi. Don't splash the phone. Say hi. Come, you guys. Swim over. Say hi to the world.
Hi.
If you guys, where are you? Hello, world. Where are you? If you could give a roll call for where you're checking in from, I'll let the kids know. All right. Hey, have you, hey,
how do you like Camp Wakanda?
It's good. It's very nice.
Right? Is it a good start?
Yes.
All right. Great, great, great. Oh, is the video frozen? I'm sorry, guys. I can't do any better. Hopefully, you know, I don't know what the quality is, but the signal gets weaker the further we go towards the bush. No, this is fresh water from the streams. This is drinkable water. Right now it's chlorinated, so obviously, you know, I wouldn't drink it openly, but none of this is salt water. This is all clean, clean, clean. And again, you know, it comes straight off of three streams in the hills. So it's some of the cleanest water you've ever seen. So, yes, ladies and gentlemen. Now, let me know, is the video and audio clear? Because I can't really tell. I really can't tell. So you have to let me know. Anybody else having tech? Right. Because I have no idea. I know I got a low signal message before. Well, I tell you what. I do have my Nikon here. So what I'm going to do, I have a little cheap tripod here. And my little portable chair. All right. So I'll get set up here on this little almost there stool. Right. And I have my D7100. So my plan is to gather footage. So I really wouldn't be able to stay on here too long with you guys. But all right, guys. So here we are. Camp Wakanda, finally. And, you know, just enjoying the beach. Unfortunately, I can't swim because I got to, you know, do my job, which is take the photographs, right? So that we have the necessary marketing materials to get the word out on this. And let me just jump in my chair here. But, yes. Oh, boy. What a land. Again, this is great. As you can see, the pool is freaking huge. Man, I don't know. You know what, and this actually isn't the entire pool. Where the pool ends is an artificial end. It continues over there for probably another 100 and change feet. There's a whole nother section to here. As a matter of fact, you know what? Let me take you on a quick tour. I'm going to take you on a quick tour while we still have sunshine. Because here, the real camping zone, because I'm going to give you a little tour right now. All right, so we're going to leave the pool behind, okay? And just to show you, see all this dips down, all of this is continuation. So all of this brush here is hiding the continuation of the pool into this vast area here. All of this is flat land that's been overgrown. And we're going to start mowing it. So all of this, see this tall tree and you see that aqueduct up there? That aqueduct is about 200 to 300 years old and still in good condition. As you can see, so because trees are growing out of the top of it. But this whole piece of land here, and look at the hills behind it. I hope you can see this, because really, you know, you cannot tell on your little screens what my two eyes are seeing in full stereoscopic 3D vision, man. It is just a vast array of the rawest bush, and this is all bamboo forest. All bamboo forest, think Japan, okay? Leading right up to the top of the hill. And there's going to be a zip line from this hill going all the way to the front of the property. God knows how many hundred feet away. So over this aqueduct, over this tall tree, all the way to the front. So all of this land is what we're going to clear. Oh, it keeps freezing. I apologize, guys. Well, I'll tell you what. Follow and I will update with actual proper 1080p video of this property that I'm going to tape as I go around here. So you'll have a better idea of what Camp Wakanda entails. But this is just a fraction. There's a river off in the direction that way. So full river running the entire length going down. And like I said, three pristine streams coming off the hill, which is what's feeding the swimming pool. Okay. And what's in here, this is actually an entire pool right in front of us here. This whole area heading back towards the main pool. There's only a little difference between the two of about maybe a 5 foot gap between the two. So all of this in here is actually a swimming pool. So we'll be able to camp here. When this is all flattened, have games here, so play games and what we want, go hiking into the woods, up to the tree, out to the river, as well as, you know, swim right here. They can literally just leave the campsite here and jump over. And the great house is behind these, this aqueduct here. So if I just walk through this little pathway, you'll see that, right? And there's an entire another flat area back here, which was once, this was once a very fancy estate. The Prime Minister himself at the time, Michael Manley, when this was in full swing, had his third wedding here. I think he married about 3, 4, 5 times. Quite a randy guy. But there's the great house right there. Again, in disarray because the locals burned it. And, you know, sadly didn't recognize the value of it. But you can see just how high this thing is. It's about maybe 30...
25 feet above my head. And all of this is original slavery days construction with some reinforcement. That's why it's so broad. And they use molasses, limestone, I think, you know, local stones from probably river stones as well, to create this. And that was the traditional way of constructing a lot of this. This used to be a working sugarcane estate, a working plantation. And it's now going to be the home of Camp Wakanda. So this is, you know, what we're targeting to be our initial master site right here. But the one that's closest to camp, you know, the main area of the camp. The true Camp Wakanda is deep in the bushes. It's a clearing in the bush, leading right up to the hill, much bigger than here. And I'll try and scope that a little bit later because I am taking a kids on a photo tour of Camp Wakanda. However, it's so embedded in the bush, I don't think I'll have signal. So I apologize for that. But you know, let's get back to the fun. I'm neglecting my duties as senior lifeguard. And I do need to take the photos, but I did just wanted to give you this quick tour here.
Yeah. Where are you? Come on.
Help him out. Me catch it. You next. Alright. Don't forget your seatbelt. You put on the helmet too quick. Now, man, you have to take off the helmet and put it over your body. See it? Right. Your head have to go down, man. No, man, this. This. Watch it. Pull it out. There you go. My head on the. Hey, catch it up. All right. Yeah, he had pulled into the side.
No, but this will come in the.
Right, right. Right. No, I know, I'm aware. Right. Right. Well, once they all get their turn, then that's it, you know? Yeah.
Then give them some more, right?
Break. All right. But I'd say, Charles, for the sake of safety for now, once everybody gets theirs, you know, then we move on, you know? Let's not tempt fate. You, sir. Yo. Pretty much all the power, but we'll do what we can. It's go-kart time. So we have been blessed. It rained like crazy and just as quickly stopped, and now it's hot and dry, so we got lucky. So the go-karts are off and on their way. All right, so here we are. The guys have bushed it down nice and low so we can see over the bush, and I'll take position here. Try and catch some of the excitement. Hey Janice, how are you doing? Wow. So here we are. Our young charges having fun doing the go-kart thing. Right there. Oh, you missed the mark, son. Hey, thank you. So Yeah. Thank you. We have drivers and crashers. Now, guys, I may run out of power. Every time you see, yep, these are go-karts. Again, you know, all part of the purpose for recreational fun. And as you can see, safety is a factor. You got helmets and seatbelts. So, not taking any chances. So.
The next person.
Hey, guys, how are you doing? All right, so. I'm probably going to run out of power, but just giving you the quick take here. The go-kart. All right. They're good. Brownfield giving them some lessons on how to work the go-kart. Because a lot of these kids have never had the opportunity to do this before. This is the Camp Wakanda, my friend, at the Jireh Eco Adventure Park. So, everybody excited? Who's excited? Come, say hello to the world, friends. Everybody's laser focused on the go-kart. Alright. I figured this would be the piece de resistance. Unfortunately, the cubbies are a little upset that they're not able to, right? Alright, hit the brake. Alright. So here we are. Welcome. So here we are. Getting the go-karts going. Yeah, all right, over there, keep going. So we're just giving the kids an opportunity to have a little extra fun before the end of the day here. Gotta keep a watch out, I don't get my ankles knocked. But it's Camp Wakanda. And here, I'm gonna try and get some cinematic angles here. Just to give you a quick view. Oh yes, man, we're trying to give them an opportunity to enjoy their young years, man, you know. And before we become all jaded adults and, you know, set in our ways, you're only young once, as I've said before. So this is just fun for the kids here. So we're glad. Thought we weren't going to get to do this today, but the rain came heavy and then just as quickly ended, and it's still overcast, as you can see there. But the rain, the car, as long as the track is dry, we're good. So just as a opportunity before it ends, I'll give you do a quick ride.
Everybody,
and
keep moving.
Everyone, stay off the track. Hey, let's go. All right, Mr. Bromfield, I may take a quick run just to show before I run out of power. Is that okay? All right. Okay, guys, hold on. I'm gonna do a quick run on the scope and then come back, all right? So, hold tight, helmet, with the extra helmet. And you know, the pink helmet, you know. Yeah! All right, beside me. Okay, guys, so I'm just gonna steal a ride from these kids, give you a quick circle around, and then come back, okay? And glasses off. As always, safety first. Got my camera with me, but I'll just keep it in my lap. All right. Uh-oh. Somebody better than gone? Hey. Don't worry, man. I'm catching for you. I always want to set the right example here. Okay? I'll try and do this quickly before the power runs out. All right. Here we go. Gas and brake. We're good? Here we go. I've run out of Mr. Brownfield. I may have run out of gas. Anyway, we're good to go. Just wanted to give everybody a quick view. So, all right,
I don't want to steal any opportunities from the kids. Oh, I didn't want to steal. Oh, I just shut up, so I don't know if I... Mm-hmm. All right. And I hope I didn't lose my glasses. I think my glasses are back there on the trail. All right.
So we have to make sure.
Right.
We have to make sure. Just keep on the brake.
Yeah, I'm on the brake.
At least 2 minutes side from the trail.
I'm gonna have to search the trail for my. You holding it? You holding it good? Hold it good. Come on, man. I wanna see. I think I dropped my car.
No,
come on. Oh, there. All right, I got him. All right. Hey. Where's the bobsled team practicing for the next Olympics? You gonna push me? All right. Let's go, boys. Push it up. This is peep. Bobsled, go-kart, people power. Why, slowest I've ever gone. All right, so, yeah, coming around. All right. I was too hard on it, man. Run it out. All right, thank you. All right. Got it? No, yes, you want to get the right. I'm going to talk to Mr. Bromfield. Poor young man, he's too short. Legs can't reach. I'm gonna see if I can get him on there. So we'll see if we can work something out, okay? All right, I'll do my best.
When is working?
Make sure you guys get the chance to ride. All right, so. Where are the lines, St. Andrew, okay?
Right up here. Five.
You got it? Can you put it good? All right. We need some strong arm, man. I wonder if it got flooded.
Let me see again.
I was cutting some hard corners, man.
Watch it, man. You call me in voice. Watch it. You call me in voice soon. Watch it, man. This is a really bad man this time.
Ah! He's got it. All right. Yeah, that seatbelt sound good? All right. Yes, man. Camp Wakanda, ladies and gentlemen. So, to send you, oh, here's Karen. She's the assistant district commissioner for Scouts. Karen, how are you doing? Nice to meet
you. Good.
All right. So you see the excitement starting. Right. The pool, I gotta take you over to the pool. Right.
1 second.
You haven't seen anything yet. Alright.
No, you have to steer. You have to steer.
There. Next time. Slow. Off the gas, come up. Wow. Take it easy. Off the gas. He's good. Wow. You know, they catch on pretty fast.
Very, very impressive. That's the aid that we can do something. More than the bigger guys. Granted, the bigger guys are important.
Yes. So, he still works something cross for you, alright? Whoa, he's coming in hard. He's coming in hard. Break. No, don't tell. Hold the brakes. Stop the vehicle.
Did you do your second trip? One for two or two? One.
One more time.
Take your time.
Easy. Right. Yeah, take him back on easy.
Come in.
All right.
Come out of the way.
All right, you did your second round. Wow, look at that smile. No one wants to smile.
Why did you do three?
It's waiting out.
Well, let me tell you something.
Mm-hmm.
You have to wait until the last before you do any more.
So right? You got yours now?
Hey! No, this is the one that will hurt people. You know.
Break. Wow, see, after I tried to put the correction. All right, sir. You good? I may have you the helmet. All right, nice. How was that? Good drive? Yes, man. Very good. All right, so. Take it easy on the gas. Just tap it, touch it. Don't floor it. Floor it when you know what you're doing.
Right,
so
Sean's helping get everybody. Oh, you're going wrong, Sean. Yes, any words? Victory is yours. Yeah. The veteran. Hold on. Gotta wait. Guys, who's next?
Yeah,
16. All right.
Who's that? Number 12?
No, the younger cubs. I'm just gonna see. So the younger cubs haven't been able to get on, but they're too small. So I'm gonna see. I didn't want him to be disappointed. So I'm very serious. So I'm gonna see if I can coordinate with Mr. Bromfield to just give them a little slow control ride around, just me and them, you know, to get them through. So we'll see. I don't want them to feel that way, you know what I'm saying? With the excitement, everybody enjoying and they don't get the chance. So, all right. Mr. Bromfield, let's say thanks from New York.
Okay, you're quite welcome. We hope we can do much more of this in the future.
Yes. One more lap. There you go. Opposite the distance. So you can see, just to show you, we're nestled between the hills there and the hills over here. So as the guys go around, and again, we get all the bush. What happened right now? It cut out? Hell, help the man now on the big strapping guy standing up here, Gima. Yeah, watch out, guys.
No.
Watch out.
Everybody keep back at the positions.
Yep. Where's the emergency crew? Hey. Woo, 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 woo.
Hello.
Stay back, all right? All right, so bring it in. Thank you, guys. I'll try and respond to your comments. I'm trying to, you know, sort of focus in on getting good video for you. And we're going to be using this for promotion for Mr. Bromfield. All right. High five, my friend. Good job. High five. Yes. High five. Good driving. So you guys learn fast, man.
All right. Cool.
Excellent.
You're number 12?
Yes.
You're number 12 and he's number 13. Number 12, right.
Where is this one? Okay. There you go. So you know what to do. I'm going to help you with the helmet.
The helmet is the last. Seatbelt is the first.
Belt on.
Right.
That's our helmet here.
Okay.
Just have a equipment faded down the line and then get it started.
Okay, put your foot over the gas now. Just put over the gas.
Okay, put over the gas.
Keep your lock in position.
See Mr. Bromfield in his elements here. They're focusing on the gas and forget to steer. Oh boy. But the secret is just taking your time until you get the swing of it and then you can really go in. Whoa! Out for the count. Alright. You're too rough, man. Hard driver. Alright, so which are so the cubbies who didn't get to go? Show me a hand. You. Alright, you three. All right, I'm going to talk to Mr. Bromfield. You're going to ride with me. We're going to co-ride. All right, I'm going to talk to him to make sure you get a chance. Okay, so touch me. Riders. Yes, riders. Nice. All right, so I'll work with you. All right, I'm going to go in this. I'm going to go with the cubbies. You get the turn, but I don't want them to feel left out. So I'm going to do a slow ride with them. So, okay, guys, thanks for watching. And we'll be back, all right? I'll be back on later with more to show and share with you. Of cub camping at Camp Wakanda, soon to be the greatest site in Jamaica with the Science Museum and all the bells and whistles. And for those of you who follow me, you know this has been ongoing since 2014. So without further ado, I don't want the cubbies to feel left off. Let's get them on the road and get them some excitement and the time of their lives, because you're only young ones. Thanks for watching. Where are the six men? Go around, go around, go around. This is for you. No, you guys have to go back. You can't come for this, okay? Next time, when you get bigger. This is not safe. Only the six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all right? Yeah. I didn't hear that. And the only people who can say okay is Mr. Brownfield or me. So, and you got a false report. But we'll see what can happen. Anything could happen. But we have to take care of business first. Mr. Brownfield. Just pointing out, Mr. Brownfield, this is where we planted the pine. And look, sorry, the two lime trees. So we're gonna have to put some sticks. We're gonna cut some sticks. I brought a handsaw. So this is like a chainsaw. Yeah. So we can cut some woods to outline so that they don't get cut. If you have to move them, move them. But for now, this is the best we could find. Okay, okay. So they're in the ground there. Yes, a chainsaw. Don't worry. So no. When we get the time, then we'll pull it out. Let's focus on the business at hand right now. All right, whoever's driving, wear the goggles, all right? Yes. All right. Yep. Can video and picture, both of them. Yeah.
So I want the road here.
You'll see. Keep walking. This is where we're going to have the main field. He's going to clear everything. Camping, everything. Who's next? Okay, I only have a few minutes of power. So here we are, the boys are helping Mr. Brownfield clear some of the future area for Camp Wakanda. So he's showing them how to use the equipment in order to clear the field. Did that frighten you? Okay, wear the glass, that's why the rest of us has to stand back. So, oh, yes, all right. Yes, this is old. This thing is over 300 years old, just about. This is from slavery days. See it? All right. So ladies and gentlemen, just letting you see this here. This is the camp area that we spoke about. That's going to be perfect right up against the hills. There's a area over here where there's going to be a jump in swimming pool, the full length of there. And this is the future camp land area. So this is the camping site. And we're getting started on it right away. Why waste time, right? So Mr. Brownfield is showing them how to use the heavy duty mower that he has to cut the grass to clear this area. So let's join them here. So we're gonna start working on this right away. There's no delay, ready for business. Oh, this is one of the big stones. Some of these stones here have to be removed. This is what he hit earlier. All right, scared everybody, huh? That's why I gotta be wearing the glasses. That's why I hope. All right. Good, so with our help, we can start getting this bush beaten back. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. First camp, and these guys are ready. Ready, right, gentlemen? To get started to make our permanent site. Not wasting no time. All right. Beating back all of this grass. And like I said, ladies and gentlemen, all the assistance we can get, we appreciate. There's a stone right here. Stone. Somebody claim this up. Where do you want them to put them? Uh-oh. Gonna have to use the megaphone. Mr. Brownfield, where do you want them to put the stones? If they find any stones. Okay, you hear this? Look out for stones and throw them beyond the wall. Throw them through the gaps in the wall, okay? Try not to hit the wall. That's a very old wall. And we want to keep it in good condition. All right? So here it is. He's showing them how to use the equipment. Now we're starting work right away on clearing our new campsite. Just to show you, I made sure to the gentleman's wearing goggles. So you guys got this? All right, Mr. Brownfield has trained them already. I'm sorry I didn't catch that, but he's going to let them each get a turn. They're each going to give some contribution and help to developing the site for themselves. Okay? And many have never operated heavy machinery before, so he's gently guiding them through this. All right. This is what it's about. We're not wasting time. It's a new Jamaica, ladies and gentlemen, a brand new day. Young man, sir, how was the experience? How was the experience? Have you ever done that before?
No,
sir. First time. See, this is what we're going to do here. Woo, find a rock. Yeah. So I don't know how he wants us to handle the rocks, but we're going to have to see what we can do. If you find any rock, just lift it up and throw it through the space over there, all right? So we get it off of this area. I'll let you know, not yet. Don't go there. Hey, red hot. Not yet. All right. Look at the concentration. Seminar lose today.
Man, come cut the bread. I want to come and take it off.
No man, not drink out of it.
Good man.
You are beating your youth.
And it's still there.
I don't know, sir. Zagasa. Zagasa school.
So, how you make that man?
Fred. My smile like him know something, you know. He's working a game. I have an angle on it. Fun eyes.
I'm going to steal.
Wait, him just learned him turn grandmaster already. Ready for take him on.
This is a chessboard. This is not a chessboard.
Hey, where you go?
You know, about forest.
You have not seen a snake yet. That is not a snake. Chess. All right. What you need to do, watch them things. Pull up a chair. But this is the game. That's the game.
No, not the original.
Then I don't know which. Checkmate is when you win.
Checkers.
Okay, gentlemen, so everybody buddied up. Let's get ready because we're going to go. You have everything? Well, don't start walking yet. Now, before you leave, we talked earlier. Did we all have a good time today?
Yes,
yes
sir.
Really? Did you have a good time?
Yes, sir.
All right. Who do we need to thank?
Mr.
All right, so.
Thank God.
Yeah, yes, there it is.
Who do you need to thank?
God.
No man.
tell them for me, no?
Say it good.
Who do you need to who do you need to tell?
God!
Say it again, let me hear it, look. Who do you need to tell?
God!
Good.
All right, there we go, gentlemen. So, with that, everybody in line? Everybody has their buddy? Okay. And a big Yagi for Mr. Brownfield. Yagi!
Yeah!
Yagi!
Yeah!
Yagi, Yagi, Yagi!
Yeah, yeah, yeah!
All right, let's go swim, gentlemen. Do not run, walk gently. You know where the pool is, take your time. Okay?
I want you to take the Yagi, but it's all right.
Oh, I got it. Sir, I got it.
Send it to me.
Please. Yeah, man, yeah, man.
I want my wife to see.
Okay, will do. All right. Yes, 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 yes. Locker room first. Well, you know the routine. Listen, you're not new to this. You know this, and I'm trusting you to maintain all the gentlemen. You know what is expected, yes? All right, come on, let's go. Yes. You left your clothes?
Yes.
All right, don't worry about it. Come on, go on, go on. We'll supervise you on the way. All right. Okay. Huh. Remember, walk, don't run. Keep together. Secure your clothes and then to the pool. The pool. All right, everybody buddied up?
Yes, sir.
Let's see those buddy hands up. I see some buddies not connected. Buddy up. Don't waste time. Hands up. All right, walk gently to the pool.
One of them.
You won't notice it after a few minutes. I can't, I'm a handful. My handful. You're going to have to ask one of the big scouts to help you, okay?
We yet.
All right.
Promise us to go in now.
Okay, waiting on permission from Mr. Russell. Hold on. We're good, Mr. Russell? Yeah, they buddied up before. You have your buddy? Get your buddy now. Okay. Okay, don't forget. Find your buddy, and we go in with permission. So what do scouts do? What do scouts do? Scouts obey the orders of those in authority. You need to learn your motto. Don't let me know it better than you. And I'm half American. Okay, everybody's got their buddy?
Yes, sir.
Permission, Mr. Russell? Granted. Permission, Mr. Brownfield? Granted. Have fun, gentlemen. Yes, remember your positions. Cubbies to the right, scouts to the left. Cubbies to the right, scouts to the left. What a nice. What a nice.
We ain't a part of step. We don't want to be part of step. We're only this day.
Hello, no, the pass is step here, so come, go back. Remember, that's where you are, that's up that side. Mr. Ray, remember, that's where you are, up there.
Thank you.
check.
No man, I'm here.
This morning, we want to talk about your future. What we want to be talking about this morning? Not my future. Our future. Say it after me. We want to talk about our future. Okay. You know, it just seemed to me as if I was your age just recently. Guess what happened? Do you know that the years fly fast? Anybody who was 10 or 14 or 15, remember when you're 3 or 4 years old? Don't seem like just by the age? Huh? You get older quickly. And you know what happened? I am 60 odd years old. Is that old? 60 odd years old. And it just seemed like just recently that I was your age. But I want to tell you some important things that happened to me when I was your age. And I want you to pay careful attention to this. Some men made a big difference in my life. What did they do? Made a big difference in my life. You know what they did? They took me to camp. Where are you right now?
Yeah.
So all these young men and all the older men took you to camp. This is an important time to remember, because when you get somewhere in the future, these things are going to seem like they're nice. Because guess what happened in the future? A lot of hard things happen to people. Tell me some of the bad things that happen to people in the future. Some of them get bam, bam. Some of them get gunshot, and some of them die. Some of them are crippled. Some of them meet up into boom, accident. And some of them can't and some of them can't. Guess what happened? In life, all sorts of things can happen to you in life. So remember, now is an important part of life. When you're a child, you don't have no care in the world. Who mother and father look after food for them? Everybody here have either a mother or a father or a family look after food for you. And guess who get all those things for you? God himself. You know, the Bible says, remember your creator in the days of your youth. Guess what happened? In the days of your youth, everything all right. Everybody enjoyed swimming with me yesterday? You went and swim?
Yes, sir.
Was it nice?
Yes, sir.
It was awesome.
Who built a swimming pool?
You and God.
Did you have to be in a swimming pool? Because you're a youth, you never have to be in a swimming pool. But you enjoy it?
Yes.
Guess what happened? What apart from swimming pool you enjoy yesterday?
Go-kart.
Go-kart! You know everybody love go-kart? Where the go-kart come from? America. And it come from a man that said, well, you know, I must do something that they youth them enjoy themselves. While you're a young man, you don't have to do it for yourself. So remember those times, because this is, you will enjoy yourself the most in life when you're young. But guess what happened? You have to remember God when you're young. If you remember God when you're young, God will help to provide for you. So what is the first verse I want you to remember? Remember the Creator in the days of your youth. I want you to say it after me. Remember my Creator in the days of my youth. You youngsters say it. Remember my Creator in the days of my youth. And guess what happened? This is big property here, big all over the hill and so on. Whose property this is?
Yes.
Who give it to me?
God.
Well, I see God first, and God give me this property. You may not give you a big property like this, no. He might give you a little property like this, but guess what happened? You love your little property because it is yours. Alright? So seek God first and seek his righteousness. Seek the right things that God wants you to do. Is Jamaica seeking God properly and his righteousness?
No.
Well, you see you 30 guys here. I want, when you come back to this camp, for you to tell me. Most people call me Uncle Prince, right? Uncle Prince, you know what I did? I seek God first and do the things that he wants me to do. And you know what happened? As you go up, you become a teenager, an older teenager, and you start to do things right, and you start to do good things in school. Next thing you know, you turn prefect. You understand me? And next thing you know, you turn head boy. And next thing you know, you're going to uni. And next thing you know, you get a big job. Like my, you see, what my daughter is?
An engineer.
She's a big person who designed the whole highway. Next thing you turn big. Mostly mine is engineer, you know. But you see, she takes over as a woman, right? If you seek God first and his righteousness and the things that are good, every time you operate things good, good things will happen to you. So seek ye first God's kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. If a man does something, you know, for doing back something, because God is your protector. Right. So you don't have to punch down a man, or you don't have to make somebody do somebody something. If you trust in God with all your heart, you will be able to help other youth, and that's what we want you to do here. Pass it on. Every youth, tell another youth that we want God to run things in your life. You know, if each one of you, 30 youth here, were to tell 30 more youth, listen to me, and that 30 youth tell another 30 youth, and that 30 youth tell another 30 youth, you know what a better place, Jamaica? You wouldn't have money for practice to shoot up, right? So each one can tell one another. So in closing, I just want to mention to you one other thing. There's 20 buses that you will be able to get one to go down, right? I want to tell you one final thing here. If you have God in your life, each and every one of you will have a personal friend. And I'm going to give you a little bit of my personal life. Right? When I was a little youth, When I was a little youth, I had a part-time life. I was a twin. Anybody who is a twin? Anybody know? Anybody who will see anybody who is a twin? You ever know anybody is a twin? Right. Who is a twin? Okay, guess what happened? From me born, me having crosses. You know, when I born, I was one of a twin. My brother weighed 6 pounds. Guess how much pound he weighed?
Three.
He weighed 6 pounds and me weighed 3. I won't go in the room because me used to nickel. Them used to talk me down, push me down. My brother beat my brother. Marvin, but me could hardly help myself. But guess what? Guess what I had on my side? You know, when I was a little boy also, I was very stubborn. Because I was so little, I didn't develop fully. And when they talk, I was like, and talk, and man, where's stubborn boy? And guess what happened? I felt very bad. But guess who was on my side? And you know, well, as a group, you know what I find when it was time to learn to read and write? I couldn't read. I could not read. Guess what happened? I don't have a little mental problem. I was suffering from a thing they call dyslexia. What dyslexia do? Make you see things backwards.
Yes, sir.
So if you see a word mark E, you know E writes up. Your E writes up backwards. So when you start to learn to read, all the little boy, I don't read, and I'm a 2-2-2-2 and read, me up. Stomach and can't read at the same time. What a bad combination. Stomach and can't read. But you know what happened eventually? I kept on with the Lord, and guess what happened? I went to high school, and guess what happened? I went to a university. And when I got to university, by the time I reach a certain level, I come third in the class. And guess what happened? After a little while, I went to get my first major job. And when I get to do my first major job, that's the first time I find out that something wrong with me. I just suffered from this year. So, you know what the purpose God has for me? My purpose is you. My purpose is to be talking to you this morning. My purpose is to be having a place that you can swim, a place that you can enjoy yourself, and a purpose to have you guys take the good news to 30 more youth, and that Jamaica can be a better place. Alright? So I'm gonna ask you to bow your heads and close your eyes now and just thank God and just ask Him to come into your life and be a new person, and that in the future you will mean a lot to a lot of other people. Alright? Let's pray. Lord, we want to thank you for this group and thank you that I had a chance to talk to them. And Lord, I ask it even now that they will have you come into their lives and make them a new person. Say for me, dear Lord.
Yeah.
I thank you for all of this that I've learned this weekend. And the training that I had during the week. And Lord, I pray even now.
And Lord, I pray even now.
That you will come in my life.
You will come in my life.
And give me a strong sense of purpose. That I may make Jamaica to be a better place. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. Thank you very much, gentlemen. And you have a good trip back to St. Thomas.
Before you leave, can we have a spray with you?
Yeah, man.
Alright, let's pray. Let's pray. Father, we just want to thank you. We thank you, God, for your many blessings. We thank you, God, for your grace and your mercies. Lord, it was by chance. No, it was by your doing that we would have met Mr. Bromfield. That in all his challenges, in all his successes, in everything, God, that you placed in his life, we're here today. We thank you, God, for his family who stood by him, who has supported him. We thank you, God, for his friends. We thank you, God, for the colleagues. We pray, O God, that you continue to touch them and touch their lives. We pray, O Lord, that you continue to bless this gentleman. He has given so much. We are truly grateful, O Father. Lord, we pray that even now you will just cover him. You will just fill him up with so many things, oh God, that when he opens his mouth, Lord, that only blessings will come out. And God, that everything that he speaks to, everything that he touches, oh God, all these things will be blessed. Abundance, oh God. Your word says, oh God, that you will supply all our needs according to your riches. Lord, we know that you are rich in this universe. And so we pray, O God, that your blessings will fall upon him. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much.
All right. Why the worried faces? It's just a little bush. And afraid they didn't get lost up in there. All right, radio man, do me a favor. You're going to head to the front. All right. Now, Mr. Russell, point out to them the field that's been cleared. All right, so run to the front, Mr. Ray. You know what? Radio man, I'll tell you what. Let me go up front then.
Yeah, man, I'm at the radio man.
Yeah. All right.
Wakanda!
All right.
Okay, keep on coming.
Pay attention to what you're doing as well. Go ahead, Ian.
Keep on coming.
Look for the orange mark.
Keep on coming. Hold your hands apart and you can balance people.
Yeah, I'll tell you what.
One at a time.
Hold my hand.
Well, you guys are the pioneers. You'll be the first scouts. It's a very, very special event. The first scouts to come over into Camp Wakanda. Where is it?
Wakanda.
First person over into Camp Wakanda. You're making history.
Now you big man, you don't need
that.
All right. Good. Walk steady. All right. Let me get Pi. Coming through. Forwarding. You all right, my man? If you let me know if you're any serious distress you're in. All right.
All right.
Watch it all. Watch it all. Coming through. Hantu hoo. All right. No, you can't, you know, because I have to lead here. But hold on to it. You have him. Yes. He's your brother right there, all right? He's got you. All right, okay. So, steady walking. See, I've marked the trail. So, all right, our choppers. Watch his head. Yo, what? Let one man be away from the other. Yo, back up. It don't have to be perfect. Just relatively clear. All right, and you see the markers. So, hold it. All right. All in line. No, I want no talking. Take in the sounds of environment of where you are. Look, I'll show you. He's wet, so he's mossy. Okay. A green snail. I'll just show you him. Green snail. He's just mossy. Go ahead. Keep walking. Keep the line moving. Stay well behind the choppers. All right. Green snail. Green snail. He's just mossy. He's been wet a long time. All right, keep coming. Green snail. Yes, watch it. He's dropping his slime and I don't want it on me. I'm just showing you. Green snail. All right. I don't think it's a species. He's just grimassy. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, he's just asking you.
Yeah, he'll be fine. What day is today?
Sunday.
What date? You don't know the date? Anybody know today's date?
29.
When?
29.
The 29th of when?
July.
What year?
2018.
2018. The vanguards, the pioneers, the first Jamaican troop and pack to enter the official future permanent site of Camp Wakanda. Step in, gentlemen. Make yourselves at home. Selected for you by the leadership. Just walk and find a spot in the clearing. Pay attention to the natural environment. This is as original as it gets in Jamaica. Keep going. And this is a nice clearance in the woods. Now, if you look to your right, you'll see it. It goes up into the hills. So this isn't all of it just yet. This is just the camping area. Keep going. Do not chop anything here. This is going to be kept pristine. You know, as a matter of fact, hand me the choppers. Give me the cutlass. I'm not getting tempted. Let me have it. Walk up. Thank you. I don't want anything chopped up here. Go right in the middle there and spread out. Welcome to Wakanda. Wanna remember the movie? You see the connection? Back to Africa, from whence we came in our bloodline so many generations ago.
Many of us will never get the chance to go back to the motherland, but we can make a little bit of the motherland where?
Here.
Right here. Keep going, spread out a little bit. You have people behind you, keep going. And I want you all to get together in a group so I can take the photo. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Let's go up a little bit more. It's just soft bush, you're not gonna hurt you. Come, that's weep old lady or something. A shame old lady, sorry. All right, so look here, come. I want you to gather right in this space here. Right here, so I can get the photo.
We're gonna pray over the site. I'm gonna ask the Lord's blessing over the site.
So gather, come on, pay attention. Gather in the area, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. We don't have all day. Spread out. Taller boys to the back, shorter boys to the front.
Who like this side? If you like it, say yay!
Yay!
This is going to go up in the Wakanda Hall of Fame. You are the pioneers, you're here when it's at its most natural and original state. Okay? Can I get a Yagi?
Yay!
Can I get a Yagi?
Yay!
Yagi, Yagi, Yagi!
Yay!
Energy! Yagi, Yagi, Yagi!
Yay!
All right. Hold now. And we're going to take the shot. So, are you good? You need to get any closer? All
right.
Come
on, you need to be in this first shot here
too. Oh, yeah, that's true. Yeah, man. Well, how could we forget our leader? All right. All right. Everybody together. All right. And shh. You, sir, I don't see no hand up. You're not separate from all. You're part of the whole. All right. And some smiles, man. Did you have fun this weekend? What? Did you have fun this weekend?
Yes.
Of course you did. I was watching you. I was taping you. All right.
Blessing over the property. And for the success of this place and for what God wants it to be for the next generation. You are the next generation of adults to come. Yes.
Yes, please. Father, you blessed us with this beautiful earth.
Yes.
Because of our deeds, oh God, we have spoilt it. But here it is, oh God, that we are in this place that seems untouched. Mm. We're thankful, oh God. We're thankful too, Father, that this wonderful gentleman, Mr. Brownfield, has decided to allow the Scouts Association of Jamaica and young people, by extension, to use this portion of property for enjoyment, for education, for training. We're thankful, oh God, that you have allowed us this weekend, as we listen, oh Lord, to the various insects, we feel the sun on our skin, we experience the different plants around, we are brought back, oh God, to nature. Nature as you intended it to be. Father, we thank you that this hair will be the future site of many wonderful things.
Amen.
We pray, O Lord, for your blessing, even at this time. And ask now that we continue to praise your name, continue to give you all glory and honor, because you and you alone are God, and none of this would have been possible without you. Thank you again. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
And first and foremost, we have to turn to Mr. Brownfield, please.
Turn.
And he said, and look to God.
Thank you, God.
Okay.
Say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Okay.
Good.
And a thank you, Mr. Brownfield. Stick it in there too, please. Please. Thank you, Mr. Brownfield.
Thank you,
Mr. Stephanie Brownfield.
And thank you, Ms. Stephanie Brownfield. One more time.
Thank you, Ms. Stephanie Brownfield.
All right. All right, guys, so let's form smallest first, Okay, follow me. And we'll head out. Do you want to take any more pictures, Mr.? And you know what? Let me see. Oh, you know what? Let me do one thing. And this is special. One very quick thing. What?
Wakanda forever.
All right, excellent. Okay, scout motto.
Be prepared.
Again.
Be prepared.
With spirit.
Be prepared.
I see. Hide it behind those. Those your eyes? Big blue bug eyes. Look, he's got bug eyes. Oh. Big blue bug eyes. You see his bug eyes? That's so scary. Let me pop the eye. All right. I want to introduce the world to Jamaica's next chess grandmaster. He's going to go all the way because grandmaster, so you know, is the highest level of achievement in chess. That is like, woo. And I know Jamaica's greatest chess player. He was just here from England. He comes here to teach people how to master chess. And I'm going to put you on to him directly. So you'll be trained by Jamaica's greatest chess player ever. I'm pretty sure he's number one. And he teaches chess in England, in the UK. And he comes here and he does works too. And he's my schoolmate. We go to school together. So officially, I've got you. So say your name, sir.
My name is Tyrese Grant.
Tyrese Brown.
Tyrese Grant.
Tyrese Grant. All right, all right. So Tyrese Grant. This man mastered chess in one evening. Mastered the game and had his first victory the same night or the next day?
Same night.
The same night had his first victory twice. against opponents. So amazing, truly, truly amazing. So we're going to get, definitely got to set this man up for a great future in chess because, wow, I've never seen anybody learn the game and master it so quickly. So we have to sponsor our good talent here and put them on the big stage, all right? So there we go. The chess master of the future in Jamaica, officially. At the first ever camping at Camp Wakanda at the Jireh Eco Adventure Park in St. Andrew, just minutes from Kingston. The new permanent future scout site for all Jamaica and the world by extension. Thank you. Arane Griffiths, good to meet you. All right. Next. Your name?
Dejan.
Dejan Rain. Okay. Dejan Rain. Got you. Your name, sir?
Vanguard.
What?
Vanguard.
What's your name?
Nathaniel.
Rain. Okay, brothers. Go over, right over there. Next. Come. Whoever's there, yeah, step right up. Your name?
Tyrell Pasco.
Tyrell Pasco. Great to meet you, sir. Next. Quickly.
Javon Campbell,
good to meet you. Next.
Anthony Graham,
good to meet you. Yes, I like that.
Siobhan Oxford,
good to meet you, Siobhan.
I'm Brown,
good to meet you. Look in the camera, Dejavon Campbell. Good to meet you. Remember, look in the camera. Come quick. Next. Your name? Scotan. What's your name?
Omarion McGowan.
Good to meet you. Next. It don't matter. Anybody, any sequence. Your name? Look in the camera.
John Williams.
All right. Ray Antonio McKenzie. All right. Next. Name, sir. Yes.
Bija Harriet.
Good to meet you. You saw he did that?
Bija Harriet.
Yes. Got you. I love that. That's what I wanted. Yes. Your name, sir?
Tejan Hamilton.
Tayshawn Hamilton. Got you. Oh, your boss come?
Sanjay Quarry.
Go. Cool. Your name?
Chavin Arthur.
Oh, the boss gone. What's your name? Amarian James. Next.
Anthony Esterine.
Yes, sir.
Milton Walker.
Your name?
Romaine Campbell.
Good to meet you. Yes.
Cleon Brown.
Yes.
Jameer Small.
And?
Romel Godwin.
Godwin, right? You got it. Godwin.
Michael Thompson.
Yes.
Asuma.
Fairweather. Good. And we did have that.
Ryan Campbell.
Good. Yes.
Kamian Johnson,
good. Rajay Biggs, yes. And the big man himself,
Tyrese Grant.
No, let me get you right.
Tyrese
Grant with a T. All right. All right. And of course, last but not least, Mr. Russell, the king. The king maker too. Yes.
Okay. Everybody in.
Ain't that man out there?
Everybody's in.
Yes, sir. All
right. Okay, Mr. Russell.
So we talk, right?
Yes, man. All right, drive them safe, you know, these are future leaders, my friends. Drive them safe, man. Yes. Yes.
No, don't touch me now. Right. And no hands go through the window.
Alright, now that I got them guys in it.
Shut the bell, shut the window.
No, man, I'm
scared.
I'm scared, man. Come on, man.
Alright.
Man, you're not good. No, he's with me, yeah. Alright, guys, have fun. Yeah, good meeting you. Until next time. Alright. Are you easy on the jokes, man? Remember, when to turn it on and?
When to turn it on.
You got it. Alright. Yes, man. Alright. There they go. That's it from Camp Wakanda. Now we're heading out. We're on our way back to town. Alright. Success.